What's going on YouTube? It's your boy Deadman JB, and today we got a video that can honestly be one of my best videos that everyone sees, or it could be just be a random video that pops up, everyone forgets about it the next day. Either one, but the way I'm trying to present this video is in a way everyone can show to their favorite content, Swool Tour content creators, and have this be a starter or a mover, just something to bring the community together on a point that we can all agree on would help Swool Tour be in a better state than it is now. We, with the recent updates and changes and things, even not even changes, things they don't even address, don't even work to improve. It's not the same game you feel like it once was, and I understand it because I'm the same way. I started playing this game in 2018, early 2018, late 2017, and I fell in love with this game ever since. I've been playing it basically nonstop. Only took like a year off due to like school and whatnot. But outside of that, I was consistently just playing Swool Tour for its story, for the expansions, Flashpoint. It wasn't until later in like 2019, 2020 when I really got into PvP. But I mean, no matter, even with like my newer time to the game, I'm still deep down, just like everyone else, had love for this game. And I think what I'm doing for this video is I plan to take everyone's frustrations with the game and things they want improved, and hoping to make it into one video which everyone can share and direct it at the Swool Tour broadsword, whoever it may be, in whatever current day and age, developers, and have this be a starter, a introduction of sorts towards making this game what the people want. And I think we can all agree on, even the developers themselves, which if one day we could get them to talk with one of us or any of us, me included, because I want to do whatever I can. No matter how much could be going through, at the end of the day, it's important that the developers do what's best for the community and the players that play the game consistently. And not even consistently, there's also a video for newer players who want to get into Swool Tour as well. And how a lot of stuff, not even graphics or like art-wise, but like a lot of the basic PvE stuff or getting into like PvE, PvP, endgame content is just super outdated and super complicated that you have to go search through a lot of YouTube videos. Like, you should be able to go into a game, not have to look up a single video for nothing. For obviously the story, for getting tacticals, for just getting gear, all of that information should be straight up forward, should be straight simple. The only thing you should be looking on YouTube videos are is like the most optimal gear, the best tactical for your character and whatnot. The rest of the stuff is what the Swool Tour devs should be working on. And these are all things that just pile up and just are just things that this game needs to take a recognize. And we start to come together in a community. So let's get it. Shout out to Biggs, as y'all saw by the intro. Him, along with many other creators like Kogasm, Dread, Cease, he's going to be one of the main people I use as I try to gain everyone's feelings about the game, along with my own, and come together to make one big statement, which I hope everyone in the community can agree with. And I try, and the reason I'm like making my own version of this is because, one of, like I said, I want to introduce everyone's versions, but I feel like I'm able to articulate it, that it's clear and simple for the developers to understand. I just don't know, have any idea how much they play the game in a competitive sense. And by what I mean competitive, I don't even mean in the PvP sense. I mean it in just a general way. Do they do crew skills? Do they work on leveling up their companions? Do they work on leveling their own characters, doing heroics, doing operations, doing flashpoints, all of that? Like, this is why I hope one day, I don't know, if maybe if this, like I said, if this is a good enough video where we could one day see a interview with one of them, that would be phenomenal. Any developer to know where their mindset is, because I think that's the biggest thing with us World Tour players right now is that we just don't even know what they're thinking right now. I just wanted to piggyback on this point real quick. When players don't know what direction the game is going, that leads to speculation. Whether it's good speculation or bad speculation, that's why I want to have this talk with someone like a developer and whatnot, so we can know where their mindset is, and that way the speculation isn't something that's for the worst and something that, you know, leaves us hopeful for the future of Soul Tour in this game. This big example I'll use is like Overwatch, for example. They've had their game director, art director, all of those come out and talk to their game, to their players, and tell them where the direction of their game is heading, which I love. And I've even seen Swultor do this. I want to give them the credit because I've seen like two or three live streams. I mean, you guys could say, oh, that's it. Yeah. And it was just understandable. But I think that's a step in the right direction, because I'm going to be honest, even when the game was like the high at its peak, I don't think we saw as many streams, as many posts as big as we've seen them now in current age, which I think is a step in a phenomenal direction. I love that from directors or like developers is showing that they're listening and they want to hear our feedback. I love that. I love that so much. And I hope they continue to do that. And hopefully maybe we can get, like I said, an interview with them or anything like that. Now I want to address the points, though, like I said, which is the point of this video that I have, and all of them I have in store, which is a lot. Point one, and I have them all in a list, so I'll just be reading them and then like rambling after, like I've been doing so far. Point one, ranked will only come back if you content creators. Well, this is actually like a PSA. Well, the creators have to come together and, you know, agree on one thing that, like, something we can all agree on. Let me know in the comments and let everyone know your opinions, because this is a video to show love for the game. But yeah, here's point one. PvP groups should be limited to four mans. And I know what people are saying. What if we have more friends we want to play with? Yes, that is great. We want people to play with their friends. This is a personal opinion. I mean, not personal, but like it's a big PvP opinion that's been going on right recently, which is premates. Premates have been a very bad thing that's been affecting the PvP recently. And one reason to the fact is that is things like elo tanking and queuing with like a tank and a healer, playing everything and just farming objective. They don't even sometimes even play PvP. There's a lot of things. There's obviously some people that play with friends, but there is also, if we're being honest, a lot of bad. And I play PvP like every day. I try and stream it every day. Shout out TV, this is DamnJB. But I play PvP like every day. And I could tell you, like, I don't think teammates are necessarily that bad, but it's in the day and age, especially with defense abilities being so pruned. People aren't willing to fight mid or fight like mid and work on damage numbers anymore, because they're afraid they're gonna consistently die over and over. With defensive cooldowns, when we have more defensive cooldowns, people weren't worried so much about dying and whatnot, because they'd be like, hey, whatever, I have my shield up and soon, I have my hydraulics up soon, I have my electrocute, which I can CC someone. They had a lot more abilities, which they'd make them feel more comfortable. So, I mean, it comes with one or the other. Either we keep the ability pruning, but then lower the group sizes, or we increase the group sizes or leave them how they are right now, but we bring back our abilities. It has to be one or the other, in my opinion. That's the only way we bring back PvP in a way people are not so timid to fight as it is now, which is really bad. Point three, explain PvP objectives. I know I've checked the codex or tutorial. It does explain Odessen, but there's all these PvP things. This should all be explained, in my opinion. For explaining PvP objectives, you should be able to go to your codex. There should be a legit tab. I don't know why there's not a tab for PvP players where they explain what the objective of each game mode. I don't care how simple or dumb it may be. It could be arena. It doesn't matter. They should all be explained in the codex. Second, better reporting system for players in general. Like, I mean, I had it prioritized for people tanking their MMR, but it should be in general. We should have people. I mean, this is my first time ever reporting someone, but I need confirmation. One, I think there should be confirmation of that. Hey, the person you reported has been successfully, suspended. And also, there's also not a reporting for, like, ruining your game, like not playing. Like, that's the main reason. I don't care if you're like losing, you're dying or whatever, not getting much damage. But it's another thing if you're just sitting on in not even spawn, you're sitting in like a place you can hide, and that way no one hits you. That is just the most vile thing I've seen in a while. So it was the same problem with Galactic Season, actually. Quick note. if in the earlier stages when people were grinding tech frags, people would just legit just stay on the side of Galactic Seasons and not even play the game, ruining the PV that mode. I feel sorry for those people because they actually probably wanted to play Galactic Seasons, but because these people were standing in the corner, they couldn't even play. Okay, I'm just going down my notepad, so I'm just gonna read everything in terrible and there you go. I'm just gonna read everything from top to bottom. So this is point 9. I don't know if I have to clear out something. There might be something pretty bad talked. But in this point 9, people never complained about pre-mades because people used to always fight and run it down. This actually goes back to my previous point, so we'll just go over quick over here. This is actually because this is me understanding the criticism the community has with PvP and PvE and whatnot. This guy says, there's been pre-mades since launch. No one's complained about for 10 years. The thing about it that though is there's been pre-mades for that long, yet one, there's more people fighting. Two, we had more DCDs. And three, we have now less DCDs, and the group, the pre-made limit is, there's no limit for that. So people with healer tank, with all their DCDs, while they're going to give probably people with just maybe, if they're lucky, one tank or one healer, with less DCDs to keep them alive. So yes, there used to be pre-mades before then. But you know what? People had more, but you know what changed before, by then? People had had most of their CC strips, and they had their DCDs stripped. And I'm not saying to bring all these CCs and all CCs and DCDs, though in some sense I am saying bring back your DCDs because things like Force Choke, well not Force Choke, but things like Undying Rage should like be a necessity. Oh, your mobility too. I forgot to mention that part. For mercs, there's no reason why your hydraulics are not a require, like a thing already given to you. That should not be something you should have to choose from. That's something that they should really look back at. Are these all the things we should be getting rid of? Is this really benefiting the player to remove all these DCDs and maybe even their CCs? Let's think about it. 1.11 is there's three people at most and they don't even play anymore because pug stomping for the higher tier players that want to keep on playing PvP. Though combat in this game is super fun. Like, I feel like, in my opinion, we should stop trying to cater to the newer player experience because, let's be honest, that's what it feels like and what it kind of is, because you're introducing farming content, dating content. Like, this is not for your end game player. It's not for the person that, like, you know, plays like 3-4 hours a day on this game. This is for like the casual player that comes back every month and a half. Check back. What's going on with Sultor? You know, what's going on? They'll say, oh, cool farm content. Oh, cool story. Oh, we'll check that out. The story. That's combat is what you should be focused most on. And that's the biggest problem, is that pug stomping is not fun. For us people that focus on the combat, and we've, perfected in a way, at least compared to the other players, when we go against these lower-end players, it's not fun just constantly just running it and just being able to get top damage every time on them. I want to be playing against other people with competition, but because these people with competition have left because things like ranked is gone, we're just left with, you know, playing against the casual player and just like making it unfair. It's not fun. Also, if we're gonna keep this way of all these abilities pruned, then we gotta limit. We cannot let pre-mades stack together, because that's something I had in a previous game, which is pre-mades were playing together, legit together, and farming objective, and because one of them tanked their MMR and the other one was good or was like higher, so they got stacked together instead of us playing with me playing with the one of the premades. It was a crazy thing. I just don't think if there's two format premades, there should never be an instance where they're playing together, which I guess in the end of the day is somewhat speculation, but I wish, again, this is again something I wish Swulter would confirm. Point 8, decrease the tactical level requirement to level 70. Well, one, I don't see why there's a problem, but two, the reason why this should be a thing is because players will not learn the rotation, their proper rotation, until they have their tactical. Because it is the case that, I don't know if Swoltor, the developers, meant to do this, but like, there's in some instances where your rotation is sometimes dependent on what tactical you have. If you're running, for example, Rage, you're gonna want to focus. Like, if you have Enrage Crush, you're gonna want to focus using your Force Exhaustion or your Force Crush before you use your Raging Burst. But if you're running Cauterized Coronary, you don't even need to worry about it. So sometimes, depending on your tactical, rotation isn't even the same. So people should learn these things earlier, which is why I think, one, okay, back on this point, it should be lowered. And another thing, Why is our tacticals not earned through flashpoints, slash operations? In my opinion, you should also be able to maybe even earn them through PvP in a way. I know, again, Shadow Seas, a lot of his videos are the ones talking about how to fix it. So I use him as an example a lot. I don't really have examples of many others because there's not many other people playing this game. But yeah.
A great example, but Life Warden should probably be given for free for players that first time do the first weekly for Arena.
Piggybacking off what he said, sometimes even if you complete your weekly, especially in a lower level one, you should be getting like something like a Life Warden or a, I don't know, something if you're like a, if you're a Juggernaut, you should be getting Grit Teeth. Heck, if you're a Marauder, you should get Grit Teeth. That's a good thing. If you're a, some people, PvPers not gonna like this. If you're a Sin or a Shadow, you should be getting Double Cloak or something like that. A general tactical that is just good in like almost every instance. Yeah, those are things you should 100% be getting. These tactics are something that you should be getting for sure. But like you said, that's PvP. But for PvE, there's no reason you should not be able to get all your tacticals through there. You have to spend 3k tech frags for your tacticals. Spend 6.5k tech frags on leveling up your on leveling up your plans just to get one set. And oh, so thankful. Now they're only 2.5k. But wait, there's also like 8 different classes. There's 8 different classes or 4 different. How I can't do the math right now with along 3 different variations. Oh yeah, and then your gold augments. I almost forgot about that part. The most important, one of the most debatable, most important ones is your gold augments are also obtained through tech frags. I don't even know what you would call this, like farming stuff. It's like grinding content. Like people want to get in there and like do fun and hard things. I know earlier, like in like when we got introduced, like 7. I won't even say like it wasn't even 7.0. When we introduced 7.2 or 7.3, I started to realize we were starting to get a little bit too casual. Like we start to forget about the fun things that make SWTOR fun is the competitiveness. Sometimes just playing, doing silly things or whatever, like going to Hammer Station and just spamming it. You know, it was not always the best, but it was always fun. I still remember memories of just like having Hammer Station with like with friends and whatnot and just grinding for our gear. That was the best. I remember 7.0, that competitiveness. I mean, I'm also a person that loved the competitiveness in like OG 7.0 when you could only choose like 8 flashpoints and those were competitive. I still think that was like a good thing. They really introduced a competition in this game, which I think was definitely needed, but it was introduced at a wrong time, which I respect Broadsword for doing, or I guess it was BioWare technically. I appreciate the SWTOR devs for doing. I appreciate y'all for doing that. But I think it's something we should like test around with. I really wish we could get more tests, man. That's the thing I want. I think we need to like lay back on getting content and look back at what do our dedicated end game players looking for. I think it's high time we finally get something like this. And this is exactly why I'm against expressing the video. I don't know how long it's gonna get. It's already 24 minutes around 25, but it's so much stuff. It's like, oh my goodness, I so much I want to keep on going on, but I know I need to keep myself short. Well, let me first say this. Tacticals you should be able to use your tacticals at level 70, and then second point, you should be getting a tacticals even when you're level, like, I don't care, level 10, level 15. No, level 15 when you queue up, you keep up for veterans. As soon as you're able to queue up for veterans, you should be immediately getting your tacticals, man. Like, you should be, honestly, if I'm gonna go even lower. You should get your tacticals, you should be able to use your tacticals at level 50. Like, it's that important of a thing to have. Like, I think it's more important than even your, yeah, it's 100% more time than your legendary implants, because your legendary implants just are damage boosters most of the time. They're not even affecting your rotation, but tacticals are, like, such a vital point. You should be getting them at, like, level 50. You should be able to use them at level 50 even. I think that's a reasonable thing. But you should, again, with that being said, you should also be able to grind through them through operations, flashpoints, any PvP, uprisings, let's not forget about those, please. and even and PvP, like, while you might not be random, or maybe it could even be random, there you go. If you don't want it to be like a certain thing, you wanted like some creativity to it, add up some spice, give you a random, I don't know, flashpoint, tactical cachet, whatever you want to call it, and it gives you a random tactical. That's fun. That's simple. That's enticing. It's up to you guys if you guys want to make it like specifically for your class, or like, so like, say everything in the, if you're a Juggernaut, everything in the Sith Warrior class, and if you're Marauders, same thing, everything in Sith Warrior class, you can make it like that, or you can. Okay, point 9. This is for the newer player, for 100% the newer player. Once you reach level 80, you should 100% get a pop-up saying, congratulations, you have reached level 80, max level. And, you know, this thing will have to be updated every, you know, major expansion. I would hope that's not too hard. If we get to 8.0 and then the level is increased to level 85 or whatnot, then you should be like, congratulate you reached level 85, level 80. It doesn't matter. Now that you've reached level 80, be sure to head to your Imperial fleet or your Republic fleet or pub fleet and head over to supplies vendor to go find more information of what your level 80, 85 gear, whatever it may be. You should that should be 100% be a thing that should be added. Letting the player know, oh wait, I'm finally max level and I can go get better, more powerful gear. Like, you know, you could word it in a way, get the powerful gear that finally suits you, allowing you to rule or be a savior for the galaxy, depending if you're light side or dark side. You know, there's like a little fun to it, a little role playing to it. And it's not like it would get annoying to other people, because like, you only have what, like 24 max level characters. Even during double XP, what, you're gonna get every 4 hours if you're really grinding for things, every 4 or 6 hours. Like, who cares? I think that's a great addition. It lets newer players know, hey, I can find my high level gear over here, or like getting started for my high level gear over there, and I can get my tacticals. Which, again, adding on to that point, you should let people know at level 50 that hey, congratulations, you've reached level 50. You are now eligible to get tacticals. So then you could let these newer players know, hey, I can get tacticals over here at the imp fleet or the tactical or the thing, which then would, I mean, it would then cause you to have to allow, well, I forgot to add this point. Another point is that you should have tacticals, the tech frags, not tacticals, tech frags be, the limit should be increased to like 20,000. That's not, I don't think that should be even a question. There's no doubt in my mind. There should be 20,000 to even 25,000 tech frags. It's at the point in time, this is ridiculous. I hate that 11K cap is so ridiculous. I don't care how like synergized it is. It needs to be getting rid of. It needs to be higher. I mean, I'm not saying there should be a cap, but there should be, the cap should definitely be higher. Oh, we're here. Point 11. I don't know how far, if this is point 11 or not. Damn, I've not been adding this gameplay in the back. Well, either way, I'm gonna add it now. Point 11. Let me rephrase this. Augments in this game, not even just in PvP, though. I will be honest, the main reason I made this point was on the fact that a lot of players in PvP they play without augments, and they don't realize how terribly horrendous they're set up for failure. I don't know how to word it any other way, but that's honestly the case. They're set up for complete failure for this, because the fact of the matter is that people look at your gear. People, even not even just your own teammates, because I mean your own teammates can expect every aspect of your gear, which is a perfect and understandable thing. There's nothing wrong with that. It is actually a comp thing to do in certain situations. If you realize that your teammate is low health or doesn't have proper gear, you use that as a way of defending them and making sure they're safe. At least I do as a Juggernaut. If I realize that this guy's, hey, my teammate's a lower level, okay, then I need to make sure I plan accordingly. But yeah, this is, I'm hopefully you guys can, you know, find these points that I'm talking on and, you know, give your own feedback of what you think you would do to make Soul Tour, not even just PvP better, but like PvE, new player experience, all that better. And, you know, hopefully bring back ranked at the end of the day. That's the end goal for at least me as a PvP player. But what would you guys recommend in this situation? And a situation where, like, hopefully we can get the community together. What would you recommend that would bring us, you know, not even just closer together, but like make us excited for newer content that gets released? I believe the Soul Tour developers want to work on content that makes everyone happy. But, you know, they got to do it in bits and pieces. So, you know, try and feed your, if you can, make your feedback a way that, you know, sounds reasonable and doable. That could, you know, get this game started and up and going back to the way it was. Back to the day, apparently, they used to get like a million freaking viewers or players a month or whatnot. But yeah, with that being said, hopefully y'all enjoyed this video. And this starts a wave that brings back the game that attracts so many people. Not even just for the Star Wars, not even for the PvP, all that, the PvE, but the community that this game once had, and, you know, bring back players that, you know, went up to play other games, play the World of Warcraft, play the Guild Wars, play the maybe BDO or maybe in some cases I guess Valorant or whatnot. You know, hopefully that attracts those people to come back, and even newer people, which I've been trying to do, come back, even or like not come back to play, give the game a try, like new players like that, even like play like younger people. I think younger people would love this game. It's just that, I mean, it just feels so like in some aspects, if I'm being honest, it feels outdated and feels like something that like they don't know if they, it's worth investing their time into. And I think it's something that they would be if it felt like it was like something to pull you in and worth grinding for, which I do think this Soul Tour is. And the PvP would just keep people going from then on, at least the younger people like myself, or even maybe they want to do PvE. Yeah, things like PvP, for a lot of younger people, PvP would be a big attraction because it is such, PvP in this game is so good. So good. I can't recommend it enough. It's like the perfect thing you could have in an MMO. That's like your combat, your animations are just so perfect. It makes you want to play and do the same thing 24/7 over. So yeah. Anyways, though, with that being said, hopefully you guys enjoyed this video, and hopefully this again makes some motion in the ocean. Anyways, though, with that being said, I'll see y'all in the next video. Take care, y'all. Peace. Basketball dreams. I hit the block and shot a different type of